Welcome to another part of our tutorial series. In this tutorial, we'll be splitting it into three parts, and it's all focused on sound. In the first part, we'll learn to place ambient sounds, which will be the audio background on the map. In the second part, we'll learn to place single sound sources, sound emitters, and their parameters. And in the third one, we'll learn to add a soundtrack. With all those elements, we'll be able to put a full spectrum of sound into your maps. We'll start with ambient zones. With them, we can set up both environmental sounds and their acoustics. Sounds set using ambient zone will be played back as stereo, 2D sound. Let's add global ambient sound to our map by inserting ambient zone from the object types in the assets window. Ambient zones work in that they activate when a player enters them. Let's scale it in such a way that it encompasses the entirety of the map, and name it in the attributes window so we can find it later. Let's select a setting fitting our map. To do that, we go to the Fields tab in the Attributes window. In the M_EffectsPresetID field, you can select the reverb type from a list of presets. In this case, we'll select Open Area. We can now set acoustics within our ambient zone, but we will still need background sounds. For every ambient zone, we have four parallel tracks. Basic ambient sounds should always be set to number 0. In track_modifiers in track 0, we'll select the sound playback option, ambient zone track play. From the available preset list, M_soundendem, let's select a sound that fits our environment best. On open maps, we should use presets with the MSA prefix, since only those will react to weather changes. Let's select ambient MSA_globalweather. By selecting a flag in S_editor_test, we can listen to the sound we selected. Now, all of the map will play the global ambient we've selected, but it's safe to assume it won't fit in every single place on the map. For every characteristic area and interior, we should add separate ambients. We can insert overlapping boxes. They get prioritized automatically, so various soundtracks won't overlap. Let's put another ambient zone on our map and scale it to fit the geometry of an underground tunnel. Now we'll select fitting settings for the new ambient zone in the attributes window. First, the acoustics. This time it will be sewers_corridor preset. Now the background sound. If we want to hear weather effects in the tunnel, we should use the MSA_tunnel_weather. If not, we can use sewers_corridor. Now we'll be able to hear the different ambients instead of just the global sounds once you enter the tunnel. Some ambient sounds can be played simultaneously. For example, we can add intensity to the sound of the wind blowing on top of the roof buildings. To do that, first we'll put in and rescale another ambient zone. It will be set within the original global zone. If we don't want to change its settings, we just don't choose a preset. Acoustics will be left as is. Now we'll go to the track modifiers field. Remember, the global ambient is played back using track 0, so don't change that. In track 1, we select the ambient zone track play option. This track should use presets with the additional_prefix. Let's select additional_wind_high. Now our ambient zone will have two ambient tracks playing. The global one, track 0, together with the additional wind sound, track 1. Let's find out if everything is working in game. We can hear the background sound on the map. On the rooftops, we can hear a more intense wind sound. And the acoustics and the sound changes when we enter the tunnel. Now we have the sound background ready, so we can move on to the next part of the tutorial.